Assalamualaikum and good morning. So today we are going to continue with a new topic. Okay, we have done with IBS. Okay, so starting from today until the end of the semester, we are going to cover the topic regarding long span structures. Alright. So even though it's a relatively different topic from IBS, but still there is a relationship between IBS and also long span structures. Okay, so today what we're going to do is that I'm going to give you an introduction to long span structures. Okay, the types, the things that you need to know about long span structures before we go into detail next week. Okay. Alright, the slide has been uploaded in your future. I hope you have downloaded the slide so you can refer to the slide while I give you the lecture lah. Okay. Okay. So as I mentioned earlier, starting from today, we are going to move on to the new topic, which is long span structures. Okay, so today we are going to have an introduction on long span structure. So what we are going to cover today is, firstly, we are going to have a look on the definition regarding what is long span structure, and a little bit history on long span structure. Okay, when it has been implemented, being constructed around the world. And we are going to touch also on the structural development of long span structure. Okay, it's also related to a little bit of history. We can see the revolution that has been made on long span structure, okay, from 18th century up until today. And then we are going to have a look on the common structural system that we have. Okay, which include long span beams, long span trusses, and also long span roof structures. Okay, so these are the things that we are going to learn in detail. Okay, starting from next week. So today I'm going to brief you what is long span beam, trusses, and also roof. Okay, before we go into detail next week, and then we are going to have a look on some of the construction consideration regarding long span structures. And finally, on today's lecture, we are going to discover about the problems related to long span structures. Okay. All right. Next, we have a look on the definition. Okay. So of course, this is the basic thing that we need to know lah before we can learn more about long span structure. Okay. Before we can learn more about long span structure, we need to know the how we can define long span structures. Okay, so what is long span structures actually? Okay, long span structures create unobstructed column-free spaces, okay, greater than 30 meter or 100 feet for a variety of function. Okay, that's what we can define long span building or long span structures. Okay, so I think the name itself is already obvious, long span. Okay, so means that you will create unobstructed, okay, no obstruction in the space of the building. Okay, and they are using less column. Okay, and the span can be greater than 30 meter. Okay, dia punya keluasan ataupun bukaan dia can be more than 30 meter. Okay, so usually why they want to create what we call it as a long span building or structures, because some of the activities involved needs, for example, visibility is important for large audience, for example, like auditoriums or covered stadiums. Okay, so auditoriums like you're going to watch a concert, football match, for example, covered stadium. So this we are talking about visibility. Okay, so when you create a long span structure, a long span building, you can have the element of visible. Okay, people can see wherever they sit in that particular building. Okay, so we are talking about flexibility. Okay, so for example, like exhibition halls, okay, and some certain types of manufacturing facility. Okay, that's also required long span structure. Okay, so as you can see, I think all of you have been in exhibition halls. Okay, and for example, we have a lot of exhibition hall in Malaysia. Okay, so we need flexibility. Okay, because when we have exhibition halls that have a lot of space, okay, we can create temporary space inside the exhibition hall to create a function or to create an event. All right, and then we are talking about large movable objects, a house. Okay, for example, aircraft hangars. Okay, so the place that we locate our airplane. Okay, airplane lah. Okay, kapal terbang kita locate. We need a space, a huge space to locate our airplane. Okay, in order to maintain it, maybe, or in order to service the airplane. So that's why we need a long span structure that have enough space to do whatever we want with our aircraft or with our airplane. Okay, so as you can see in the previous slide just now, there are three types of structural system for long span structures. Okay, we're talking about long span beam, long span trusses, and also long span roofs structures. Okay, later we're going into this system later on. Okay, so a little bit history of long span structures. Okay, so this is one of the earliest building in the world that built based on long span structures, which is located in UK. Okay, the Crystal Palace for Great Exhibition. Which has been built in 1851. Okay, so it is an exhibition hall lah. Okay, so it's been constructed almost entirely using cast iron, timber, and also glass, which includes the largest volume of space ever up to that time. Okay, so up until 1851, this is the largest long span building in the world. Okay, to the lightest construction and highest technologies available lah, okay, during that time lah, okay. So the overall size of the building was vast, okay, vast means very big, okay, measuring 563 times 139 meters, okay, covering a ground area of 7.3 hectare or 18 acres, okay. So as you can see from this dimension area, we are talking about a huge building that have a long span structures lah. So the galleries measured more than four times the size of St. Peter's in Rome. Okay, previously St. Peter's is the largest, world largest building before this building has been constructed. Okay, so as you can see, the size is four times bigger than this St. Peter. Okay, so dia defeated St. Peter quite a long way lah to become the largest building in the world during that time. So the whole building was completed in 6 months. Okay, so even though we are talking about a huge building, but it only took 6 months to be completed. Okay, and why it is can be completed within reasonable or faster time because of standardization and mass production of the components. Okay, here we are talking about IBS. Okay, so as we have learned, IBS is about standardization, it's about mass production, okay, it's about repetition and so on. So as you can see, the element of IBS already come into picture in the 18th century. Okay, dah lama dah IBS ni sebenarnya. So barulah for the past 20 years barulah kita develop it as a way forward for the construction industry in around the world, including Malaysia lah. Alright, so here are some of the view of the Crystal Palace. Okay, sorry. This is the exterior view. Okay, so as you can see here, the real pictures of the Crystal Palace ni, okay, which has been built in 1851. Okay, so when we're talking about history, beside that Crystal Palace, which has been built in 1851, during the old days, normally when we're talking about long span structure, they normally apply long span structures on bridge, okay, or viaduct. Okay, viaduct ni laluan pejalan kaki and so on lah. Okay, so mostly in the early 19th century, most of the bridges and viaduct were constructed using timber. Okay, so previously, the material used for constructing a timber in the world is mainly using timber. Okay, so the timber was expected to last 30 years, but as labor cost for maintenance increase, the bridges were replaced and most has gone by 1940. Okay, so most of the bridge that has been made by timber has been either being demolished or replaced by other materials lah. Okay, so previously we are using timber as our material for long span structures in the form of bridge. Okay. So next, we are going to talk about the purpose of long span structure. Okay, the objective of having a long span structure. So there are three common purposes of long span structure. Okay, the first one is communal activities. Okay, so enables a large group of people to assemble without obstruction by the presence of supporting column. Okay, so communal activities ni we are talking about for example like masjid, okay, maybe temple and so on. Okay, so we have we required at one time, that place required a large group of people, okay, to be inside in the building, so that we need structures that have very minimum obstruction lah. Okay, so in that case, we need to develop a long span structure to achieve these activities. What we call it as a communal activities. Okay. The next purpose is economic activities, okay, for manufacturing and commerce, okay, etc. For example, Ethereum and shopping complex. Yes, okay, you can see if you have been to shopping complex, I think we have, for example, Mid Valley. Okay, if you have been to Mid Valley, there is one section in that building has an Ethereum. Okay, as you can see in that Ethereum, they will conduct or they will held a lot of events on that Ethereum, okay, a lot of space, okay, like we have in ICT Mall in Shah Alam here. Of course, you didn't have an opportunity lah for the time being to explore Shah Alam, but later on, maybe next semester you can explore. You can see most of the shopping complex have an Ethereum that can hold and activities, for example, like event or commercial activities, okay, in that particular building. And the last purpose of long span structure is for prestige and status, okay. So dominate the landscape and easily become landmark lah. Okay, so as you can see, most of the long span structure or long span building is become a landmark in certain area. Okay, so they are and also when that particular building has become a landmark, in some sort will bring a free advertisement for the owners or even for the city. Okay, so you will have to indirectly will have the economy of that particular city lah. When we have some sort like landmark, people will come there and indirectly will contribute to the economic activities in that particular countries or areas. Okay. Alright, the next thing we are going to touch is we are going to answer this question. Okay, why we need a large span structure? Okay, why we need? Okay, the first reason why we need is because of function. Okay, functionality. okay, influence the adopted structure on the purposes of for which the structure was erected lah. Okay, we are talking about function. Okay, so again, we relate to the previous slide. We are talking about the purpose of the long span structure. Okay, we need a large or long span structure because of certain objective that we need to achieve. For example, religious punya things, okay, untuk semayang, untuk and so on. So we need a space that can hold a large numbers of people at one time. Okay, so that's why we need a large span structure or long span structure. Okay, the next reason why we need a large span structure is because of aesthetic value. Okay. Excuse me. Okay, when we're talking about aesthetic value, of course, any design, any structures that we build must have an element of aesthetic lah. Okay, so this is also one of the criteria of architect lah. Architect, when they want to design something, of course they want to have the element of aesthetic in their design. Okay, so that when you have the aesthetical value in your design, in your building, you can easily attract people to come to your place lah. Okay. And the last reason why we need a long span structure is because of the economic value lah. Okay, so when you build a long span structures, you can cut costs maybe on the labor and also materials lah. Okay, because you will reduce the required numbers of column for your project. Okay, so you're using less column means less material. So means also less labor required lah in order to construct the column in your projects lah. Okay, so that's among the reason why we need long or large span structures in construction industry. Okay, next we are going to see some of the application of long span structures. Okay, you can see here there are a lot of application of long span structures. Okay, which can be applied on community building, sports complex, okay, swimming pool roof, okay, manufacturing facilities, railway stations, okay, convention center, exhibition hall, aircraft hangars, okay, and also museum, right? So that's among the application of long span structures. Okay, so it's totally different thing from tall building. Okay, tall building which you have learned with Dr. Ani, okay, which is different. Okay, it's a tall. While long span is we are talking about wide. Okay, kelebaran bangunan tu as wider as possible lah. That's why we call it as a long span structures. Okay, so these are some of the application of long span structures on the type of building that we have. Alright, next we're going to talk about the structural development. Okay, again, here we are going to see a little bit of history of long span structure in the form of material as well. Okay, so as you can see, the use of material in long span structure between the 13th and 15th century, okay, rural architect took on different regional forms due to material use were timber, stone and clay. Okay, between during this time, this is the main material that has been used for long span structure. Okay, from 14th century, okay, stone and brick were used as structural material for the house construction. Okay, the material changes due to main reason for their spread was fire resistant in timber. Okay, early timer constructed by Roman was simple beam structure of hewn tree trunk spanning between pile timbers. Okay, again, as I mentioned just now, most of the construction of timber during this time is using timber lah. Construction of bridge during this time is using timber. Okay, so so this is the early development of materials in long span structure. Huh. So this is the early development of long span material used in long span structures lah. Okay, so mainly they are using timber, clay and stone and stone and brick. Okay, from 13th century sampai lah 15th century. Okay, and here some of the revolution of long span structure. Okay, so as you can see, after that, from time to time, the idea of using steel has come into pictures. Okay, starting from 18th century. Okay, as you can see, Paddington Station in London. Okay, and then 1849, again they are using, they are developing a railway station, okay, in Liverpool, okay, Lime Street station. Okay, here come the place where we're talking about just now, okay, the Crystal Palace in London, 1851, and then 1868, St. Pancras station, okay. Most of them, because during the old days, the main transportation use mostly is train lah. Okay, that's why a lot of development of long span structures in the early 18th centuries are using railway station. Okay, so 1874, okay, York Station. And then in Paris, 1879, they're developing an aircraft hangar. Okay, and then again, Galerie des Machines also in France, 1889. Okay, they are using for hanging as well. And in also in Paris, 1898. Okay, this one is more on exhibition hall lah. Okay, the Galerie d'Orléans, okay, Paris. Okay, that's some of the revolution of long span structure around the world lah, especially in European countries. Okay, by the late 20th century, durable upper limits of span were established for this type. Okay, so as you can see, from time to time, the advancement in technology, advancement in materials, we can see more and more long span building has been constructed around the world. Okay, and the size, the span become wider and wider from time to time lah. Okay, so as you can see, as for today, the largest covered stadium at a span of 200 meters square, alright, 200 meters. Okay, the largest exhibition hall had a span of 216 meters. Okay, the largest commercial fixed wing aircraft, which is hangar, had a 70 to 80 meters span hangar. Okay, so the major evolution in long span structures have occurred in this aspect of shift from in situ to precast construction. Okay, that's why we can see more larger long span building or long span structure has been built around the world, because of we are talking about modern construction method, okay, which is precast or IBS lah. Okay, that's why we can build okay, again, as I mentioned, because we are shifting the construction method towards a more modern method of construction like ABS, so that's why we can build more bigger, more larger structures lah, okay, around the world. Okay, as you can see, this is the development of long span structures. Okay, so yang ni in Rome. Okay, only have this new span around 100 plus year, and then in Istanbul, Turkey, more bigger. Okay, and until they build Superdome in New Orleans lah, US. Okay, so it's have more than 700 feet dia punya span. Okay, so that's how we can see the development of long span structures around the world lah. Okay, so it's getting bigger and bigger lah. Okay, so again, as I mentioned earlier, we have shifted the material use. Most of the older generation, they are using timber as their main material for long span structures. But nowadays, we are moving towards using steel as our material for long span structures. So even though it's a different material, but still, these two has been considered as IBS lah. If you use these two materials, you're using IBS in your long span structures. As is as simple as that lah. Okay. So next, a little bit example of long span structures. Okay, is considered as currently is one of the largest long span structure in the world. Okay. Which are located in Canada, okay, which is known as Rogers Centre. Okay, previously, the building is known as the Sky Dome, Toronto, Canada. But this company, Rogers Company, ni, I think is a mobile company in Canada, bought this building and renamed it to Rogers Centre. Okay, so here are some of the details of this building. Okay, it's been constructed in 1986. Until May 1989. It took about almost 3 years lah, 2.5 years roughly. Okay, the cost is 570 million okay, to construct this dome. Okay, alright, this is this Sky Dome is the first and only stadium to have a fully retractable roof. So means that the roof is movable. Okay, you can close when it's raining, for example. Okay, so it will not disrupt the match lah. Okay, as you can see, this stadium is center is a stadium for baseball match lah. Okay, so if the match is being run, suddenly it's rain, you can close the roof. Okay, so this is the first and only stadium in the world that that have the roof that is movable. Okay, or retractable. Okay, so as you can see here, when the weather is good, okay, usually from April 1st to April 1, the roof can be rolled back. Okay, you can open the roof. So uncovering the complete fill area and over 90% of the seats lah. Okay, so almost everybody will be exposed to weather lah if they open the roof. Okay, the widest span of this roof is 209 meters and height dia adalah 85 meters. Okay, for this roof. Okay, here some of the here are some of the features of the roof system of this Rogers Centre. Okay, the roof is made up of steel trusses. Okay, covered by corrugated steel cladding. Okay, corrugated. Okay, remember kalau you tengok lecture steel framing system, we are talking about corrugated. Dia beralun. Alright, covering the cladding is a PVC single ply membrane. Okay, dia cover dengan membrane. Okay. Cover the cladding. And then they have a series of three movable panels and one stationary panel. Okay, maksudnya they have four panels, three movable, satu tu fix. It's not move lah, station, they stay there. Okay. Panel one rotates around 180 degrees while panel two and panel three telescope straight forward lah. Okay, so nanti ada one shot video kita boleh tengok how the panels move. Alright, the roof runs on system of steel tracks and bogies. Okay, there are 76 bogies all together with 10 horsepower motor inside. Okay, some sort like machine that will roll the roof panel. Okay, so it takes 20 minutes for the roof to open or close as it moves at a rate of 20 meters per minute. Okay, in 1 minute, they can move up to 21 meters. Okay, so as you can see just now, the span is about 206 meters. So roughly it took about 10 minutes kot, to fully cover the stadium. Okay, the roof area is 31,525 meters square. Okay, the roof weight itself 11,000 tons, and is held together by 250,000 bolts. Okay, yang tighten the roof weight. So, okay, dia gunakan 250,000 screw or bolts. Okay. Okay, so this is the schematic dimension or drawing of the roof lah. Okay, so this is a fully covered, and then they will open. Okay, 180 degrees. This is the panel one. Okay, dia boleh close 180 degrees like this. Okay, and then yang lain semua dia straightforward. Okay, yang bahagian atas ni lah. Okay, panel lah. Here some short video of. Okay, so that's 180 degree lah. This is panel 1. Okay, this is panel 2 and 3. Tadi yang move straight forward. Okay, panel 1 and 2. Okay, so that's the uniqueness of Sky Dome which is located in Toronto, Canada. Okay, itu 1980s. Okay, kita dah boleh have that kind of technology. Okay, sekarang ni tahun 2020, of course, more and more unique design of long span structures is available around the world lah. Okay, next we are going to talk about common structural system. Okay, so as been stated in the beginning of the slide, okay, structural system of long span structures involving these three, okay, long span beam, long span trusses, and long span roof. Okay, so next I'm going to touch briefly on these three structural system. Okay, starting next week barulah kita look at more details about ni lah. Okay, so firstly we have a look on long span beam. Okay, so types of long span beams include parallel beam approach, composite beam with web openings, cellular composite beam, tapered girders, and hunch composite beam. Okay, so this some of the example of long span beam lah. Okay, so the difference is the shape of the beam je lah. Span dia sama lah, dia sepanjang. Okay, cuma bentuk dia berbeza. Okay, the long span beam lah. Ada yang solid, ada yang the hole macam ni, dia ada yang solid like this. Okay, later we are going to have a look in detail lah. Okay, on this part. And then second structural system of long span structures, trusses. Okay, a truss is essentially a triangulated system of straight interconnected structural system lah. Okay, it's what we call as a trusses lah. Okay, they interconnected. Okay, it's a triangulated. Okay, means that dalam bentuk piramid jugalah, segitiga. Okay, so the most common use of trusses is in building where support to roof. Okay, so kita gunakan to as a supporting component for roof, floor and internal loading such as services as suspended ceiling. Okay. Right, types of long span trusses include Pratt truss, Warren truss, knot and light truss, sawtooth truss and fin truss. Okay, ini different type of truss lah. Okay, ni example of roof trusses lah. Okay, so it's a triangulated. Okay, this is what we call it as a triangle. Okay, triangle. Okay, it's interconnected lah. Okay, to make it roof trusses. Dia ada different type lah. Okay, so membezakan dia adalah dia punya cross section ni. Okay, nanti kita akan tengok in detail juga. And the final structural system that we have is a long span roof trusses. Okay, long span roof are generally defined as those that exceed 12 meter in span. Okay, and it create flexibility, column-free internal spaces, and can reduce substructure costs and also construction times. Okay, so when you use a long span roof structures, okay, you can cut costs on especially on substructure works. Okay, in terms of the foundation, okay, construction time also will be much faster lah. Okay, they are commonly found in a wide range of building types such as factory, warehouse, agricultural building, hangar, large shop, public hall, gymnasiums and arenas. Okay, so this is the types of long span roof structures. We have tensile, folded plates, dome, okay, macam sky dome tadi, shell structures and portal frames. Okay, so kita akan tengok in brief before we go into detail later on next week. Okay, so this is portal frame, one of the types of long span roof structures. It was first developed during the Second World War and became popular in the 1960s lah. Okay, so they are using it in a lot of type of building. Okay, so this is what we call it, a portal frame, as you can see. Okay, and mostly kat Malaysia pun kita banyak nampak this type of portal frame lah in warehouse. Okay, dekat warehouse, factories dan sebagainya. Okay, so we have also dome structures. Okay, so dome in architecture is hemispherical. Okay, hemisphere. Okay, size dia. Okay, dia seakan-akan nak bulat. Okay, so evolve from the arch, usually forming a ceiling or roof lah. Okay, macam sky dome tadi. Okay, domes first appear as a solid mounts and intended adaptable only to the smallest building. Okay, so but nowadays it has been used on a larger building lah. Okay, so previously found in Middle East, India and Mediterranean. So basically the Romans introduced large scale masonry hemisphere lah. Okay, orang Roman yang mula-mula use large scale dome using masonry, okay, using bricks lah. Okay, so here some of the example application of dome. Okay, so the hemisphere lah, okay, tak adalah bulat betul. Right, and then we have cell structures. Okay, cell structure in building construction, a thin curve plate structure shaped to transmit applied forces by compressive tensile and shear stresses that act in the plane of the surface lah. Okay, so never mind, nanti kita akan tengok more detail on this lah, on each of these roof structures lah. Alright, and then this shell structure construction began in 1920s. Okay, so the shell emerged as a major long span concrete structure as after World War II. So thin parabolic shell vaults stiffened with bricks have been built with span up to 300 feet, 90 meters, okay, during this time. Okay, so nowadays it has been evolved. Okay, kita boleh nampak variety of design shape of cell structure around the world lah. Nanti kita akan explore more on this part. And we have a folded folded plate as well. Okay, which assemblies of flat plates or slabs inclined in different direction and joined along the longitudinal edges. In this way, the structural system can carry loads without the need for additional supporting beams along mutual edges. Okay, so they will reduce the numbers of required beams if you use this design of roof structures, okay, which is folded plate lah. Okay, so dia punya shape like this lah, folded. Okay, can call it as a corrugated juga lah, dia macam beralun sikit. Alright, nanti we are going to explore more on this part as well. And the last one is tensile structures. Okay, which is involved a tension members, dynamic types of modern architecture that are celebrated for their incredible versatility. Okay, so among the types of long span roof structure, this is one of the latest one lah. Okay, because of environment technology, kita boleh guna tension members untuk tarik dia punya fabric Okay, so kita boleh use develop unique such as for roof covering and so on. Okay, so this is one of the latest, as I mentioned earlier, latest roof structures that been used around the world. Okay, tensile structures. Okay, so that's the types of long span roof structures. Okay, so we have three structural system for long span structure, which involve beam, trusses, and also roof. Okay, we are going to explore more starting from next week. Okay, so kita akan tengok lebih lagi later. So next we are going to talk about construction consideration. Okay, the most appropriate form of structures will depend on functional and requirement type of building. So kita nak consider whether we want to use long span structures or not. This is the criteria. This is the factors that kita akan tengok. Okay, kita akan first we are talking about function, apa function requirement dia, jenis bangunan dia. Okay, adakah dia untuk exhibition, adakah dia untuk what purpose. Okay, so we have to discover that. Alright, span to be covered. Okay, the size of the span. Okay, berapa wide dan sebagainya. Okay, internal height of the building. Okay, so this is also we need to properly consider when we want to construct the long span structure. Okay, the material used for our long span structures. Okay, so currently nowadays most of the material used for long span structures are made from steels. Okay, kebanyakannya sekarang dah guna steels lah. Okay, timber dah kurang lah. Okay, still ada but more on steels lah. The material used for long span structures. Okay, lighting requirement. Okay, because we are talking about long span. Okay, bigger space in your, for example, like exhibition hall. Okay, we need to properly design the lighting so that we must make sure every section of that building will be covered with lighting lah. We'll get enough lighting. Okay, so we need to properly design our lighting when we are talking about long span structures. Okay, speed of construction. Okay, of course, even though we are talking about long span structure, larger structure and so on, but the construction time will be reduced a lot lah when you are using, especially when using IBS. Of course, when using steel, we consider as an IBS, so the construction time will be reduced lah. Okay, nature and magnitude of the loads. Okay, so again, we are talking about loading, because when you use long span structure, you reduce the numbers of column. Okay, so you need to make sure the size of the column that will be used for your long span structures is enough to support the loads lah. Okay, so you need to, as an engineer especially lah, you need to properly design your column. Okay, because you dah kurangkan column. Okay, for example, you only use U4 column. Okay, so you need to make sure the loading, the size should be sufficient enough to cover the load given by other components of the building. Accommodation of services. Okay, so for MNE purposes, okay, mechanical and electrical, okay, wiring, okay, aircon and so on, so you need to consider that. Okay, aesthetic consideration, of course, even though it's a long span, just for example, like exhibition center is kotak, rectangular je. Okay, tapi macam mana how you can create the element of aesthetic in your building. Okay, so you need maybe your facade or you punya building envelope tu lebih attractive and so on. Okay, and the last consideration you need to give is foundation lah. Okay, so in terms of foundation, okay, macam mana you nak design. Of course, we're talking about, for example, you want to use portal frame. It's just as using steel, lightweight steel dan sebagainya. Of course, the size of the foundation will be reduced lah. Okay, so you need to properly design also your foundation. Okay, when you're talking about long span structures. Right, the last part of today's lecture is about problems. Okay, problems related to long span structures. Okay, regarding study done by Ruby in 2007. Okay, so there are some key question a designer should find answers. Okay, when you are talking about long span structures. Okay, the first question, we are talking about loading trajectory. Okay, what is the loading trajectory for the structural system to be developed? Okay, so you need to calculate your loading first, okay, before you can properly design your long span structures. Okay, so how can the productive use of the structural member in terms of span, size, quality, quantity of short pieces and constructability be optimized? Okay, so we are talking about productivity. Okay, so again, in order to have element of productivity, in order to enhance the element of productivity in your long span structures, perhaps you can adopt a more modern method of construction, which is IBS lah in this case. Okay, how can bracing system determine from a structural perspective be efficiently incorporated into the initial architectural layout? Okay, if you remember dalam lecture topic steel framing system, I couldn't remember apa lecture 5 or 4. Okay, when talking about steel framing system, kita ada dalam video tu saya explain pasal bracing. Okay, so kita kena tengok the requirement of bracing in our design lah. Okay, so ada certain part of building yang kita kena letakkan bracing as extra support for our structures. Okay, we are talking about long span. Okay, of course, we need extra support to give stability and verticality to our structural system. And then we are talking, how can shock propagation be efficiently utilized to reduce haulage costs if it will be shipped and not fit built lah. Okay, when we're talking about long span structures, okay, we are talking about bigger construction or bigger structural system, bigger column. Okay, so macam mana kita nak transport okay, column tu. Kalau you tengok macam the construction of Bird Nest Stadium. Okay, Olympic Stadium in Beijing tu. Okay, Stadium Sarang Burung tu panggil. Okay, so kalau you tengok, kalau you boleh tengok dalam YouTube, you boleh tengok video construction dia. Dia punya problem adalah, even though dia guna IBS, tapi dia gunakan steel, IBS, tapi dia punya problem adalah size steel tu yang terlalu berat. Okay, sampai dia kena cari crane yang, the largest crane in the world yang boleh angkat besi tu. Okay, so problem-problem macam tu dia kena tengok. Okay, kena consider lah. Okay, when we are talking about long span structures ni lah, sebab dia involve heavy material. Okay, so kita kena tengok sama ada kita boleh transport, easy to transport or not. Alright, and then what will be most effective construction flow order? Okay, so kita kena properly susun our method and so that we can make sure the development of the structure has been done smoothly and efficiently lah. Okay, at what strategic location would epimerical bracing would be placed while construction erection is still in progress? Okay, so as I mentioned earlier, some of the bracing ni sometimes will be required temporary. Okay, dia tak semestinya permanently kita kena ada bracing ni. Okay, maybe sebagai permanent temporary support before the connection has been will be welded ke, for example. Okay, sebelum kita letakkan permanent punya connection, maybe kita kena have some sort like temporary bracing to give support. Okay. So kat situ pun kita kena tengok, okay. So strategic location dekat mana kita nak pergi support. So macam the construction of Bird Nest Stadium tu, dia gunakan sebelum dia nak weld sarang burung tu, kalau you tengok sarang burung yang besi, besar-besar tu, besi dia tu, sebelum dia nak sambungkan dia, dia gunakan hydraulic jack as a temporary bracing support, okay. Ada berapa ratus, saya ada more than 100 hydraulic jack yang support roof dia tu. Okay, so dia support roof tu dia temporarily. Bila dia dah weld, dia dah sambung semua connection dia, dia dah welding semua dia punya roof structures dia tu, baru dah dia remove the, the hydraulic jack. Okay. Alright, the last one, how will the determined construction flow order be applied to minimize the use of temporary props for truss erection during erections lah. Okay, again. Okay, so macam mana kita nak pastikan, kita dah susun ni dulu, macam mana kita nak pastikan the implementation. Okay, so we need to have a proper person in charge yang boleh properly monitor, okay, the construction flow dan sebagainya lah. So So all these questions carefully evaluated will guide the designer in providing a functional design which can easily be integrated in the construction interaction process to achieve the best result and reduce overall cost with prompt project delivery lah. So kalau as a designer sebab dalam when we talking about long span structures, design stage ni very critical lah, it's quite critical lah sebab we are talking about large structures, okay. So kita kena properly plan dan sebagainya. So if the designer consider all this question when they design, so at the end of the day, they will not face a lot of problems lah when come during the construction stage. Okay, masa construction stage ni kuranglah masalah-masalah kalau dia betul-betul consider all this question during the design stage. Okay. Alright, so that's all for today for the topic of introduction to long span structures. Okay, and that's all right. Any question? Okay, before we end up the session, okay, and next week kita akan move on to the new topic lah. Still long span structure tapi more detail. Okay, on long span beam, trusses and also roof structures. Okay, kalau tak ada, alright, before I stop, okay, so I give you additional material dalam your future. Okay, you can open your future, you can go to learning activities. Okay, so you go to lecture 8. Introduction to long span structures. Okay, there are a few videos yang you boleh tengok to get more understanding, more idea about long span structures lah. Okay, so I have attached the link here. So after this, selepas kita habis session video meeting ni, so you boleh straight away tengok kat sini lah. Okay, so again, saya boleh track sama ada you dah tengok ke belum lah. Okay, dekat sini saya boleh track. You guys look and watch the video or not. So after this session, you can watch the video. Okay, any question? Hey, if not about the topic, maybe you have question about your assignment. Ada soalan pasal assignment yang tu. So far macam mana assignment you all? Okay. Anyone?
Okay, okay.
Hey, boleh calculate the IBS score?
Boleh, Doktor.
Alright.
Okay,
InsyaAllah boleh.
InsyaAllah
boleh. Saya pun tak ingat dah. Next week nak submit lah?
Yeah.
Next week nak submit. Okay.
Next week.
So ada seminggu lagi. Macam mana progress? Okay.
Okay, Doktor.
Alright. So you have to submit 6 January. Okay, you have 1 week lah. Okay, so if you have any questions, if you have any question later on, you can ask in the group lah. Okay, kalau tak nak tanya dalam group, maybe about your assignment, maybe you can PM me, directly PM me, tak ada masalah. I will answer your questions lah. Okay, so that's all for today. I'm going to meet you again next week on more info about long span structures lah. We are going to dig more about long span structures starting from next week. Okay, so that's all for today. Thank you for your time and commitment. Take care and don't forget to submit your assignment by next week, 6 January, okay, through your future. So that's all. Take care, stay safe, and assalamualaikum.
Waalaikumsalam.
Thank you, Doctor.
Thank you, Doctor.
Thank you, Doctor.
Thank you, Doctor.